Last video, we talked about the first four questions that you should include on your conclusion section, and we're going to finish it up right now. So after you've actually made claims and defend that claim with evidence and talked about why that evidence should be trustworthy, now you have to talk about why shouldn't you maybe trust the data? Why are some of the things that could have been better? So what are some of the things that went wrong? Why are some of the things that could have been affected because of that? And how could you improve that? Okay, so how does that look like in exemplar? So if you look at the exemplar we did, I have a section that's called Addressing Limitations. And I start by saying the things that possibly went wrong and how that could have affected my data. So inconsistency in measurements or control could have skewed the data, making the results invalid. So you see how I'm acknowledging the impact of that on my actual lab. And then I'm going to talk about what are those actual errors. Possible errors could have occurred in inaccurate measurements of the amount of acid or base added to the solutions or water added to the plants. Future experiments can take care of that by using adjustable pipettes to dispense the liquids precisely. So I am telling you what went wrong and how it could be fixed. But because limitations is plural, I do another one. I also say the measurements of length were also perhaps not the most precise way to measure the plant growth, as other factors like leaf health or count might also have mattered. So perhaps in future experiments, we could use a precise balance to measure the mass at the end of experiment as well, to try to actually take better measurements of growth. In future experiments, it also might be wise not to plant two seeds per pod, because they may have competed for resources, which could have affected the tough conditions they were already in to begin with. So notice I am giving ideas on what I could improve on my design in the future. I'm acknowledging what could have been going wrong, and I'm actually saying how could that affect my results by saying it could actually skew the data and make it invalid. I'm almost done. Now I just have to go back and actually talk about, why does this matter? What have I learned from this that I can use in real life? Why does it matter for science? And what is another direction that I can head on in a future experiment? So you can see me doing this here on the results section. Pardon, conclusion section. So when it comes to the significance, I said the study shows that pH is an important factor for plant growth, and it shows that acidity and alkalinity can affect life's chemistry. So it may be important, say, for example, if you have a diet that stimulates a proper pH inside of you, this could matter, right? It could also matter for agriculture, because maintaining soil quality could help plants grow better. And that's obviously important because thousands of people have to eat the food. It's even important because acid rain can actually hurt plant growth. So say no to air pollution. So you see, I'm actually talking about how it affects real life. And sometimes you have to get creative with this, but you can do some research also to find some of the reasons. And you always ask your teacher. He is happy to help you out. As far as directions for future study, you make another research question, just like you did in the beginning, where you say the effect of blank on blank, where you're trying to figure out how one thing affects the other. So I've already researched how pH affects it, but I make these drastic changes in pH. So now I'm going to say, why don't next time maybe we do slight changes in pH to see if the slight changes can make a difference? Or we could also see how something else, another factor like heat, could affect the plant growth. And so that is how you write a good conclusion section. We have one more video where I'm going to talk about, go through the rubric and see how this actually gets scored. I'll see you guys then.